I hold in my hands the preliminary inquiry report released in an Italian court yesterday. This says that the company Finmeccanica, officials of the company promised and managed to pay through brothers Julie Tyagi, Doska Tyagi and Sandeep Tyagi a certain amount of money not yet quantified to Air Chief Marshal Tyagi Shashi, Chief of Staff in the Indian Air Force from 2004 to 2007. This is the first time the name of any chief of any of our services has come out in a bribery case. Joining us live from his residence at this time is Air Chief Marshal S.P. Tyagi. With me in the studios, my colleagues Gaurav Sawant and Shivarur, who've been tracking this story very, very closely. I want to go across first to Air Chief Marshal Tyagi. Now, over here, sir, we've got court documents presented in an Italian court which say that your cousins arranged for money to be paid to you by the company that sold India these choppers for VVIPs, and that the Italian court believes that this money has been delivered to you, sir.
What do I say? I mean, I've read this report. I have, first thing in the morning, at, or maybe around 8:30, I read this report, and all I can say is I was shocked. The first reaction was, what is this all about? You are aware that this these reports have been coming out in the Indian Express for some time now. And my cousin's names have been figuring in it earlier as well. Earlier there was only a hint of my involvement. Today the Italian government report seems to suggest that I am involved. From what I understand, they have said that I was paid money to tweak the requirements to suit the company. After all, I am assuming some bribes were paid for some reason, and the reason was to facilitate the Augusta Westland into taking part in this competition. Now, I totally deny this. This is actually horrifying because no requirements were changed. During my entire tenure from 2004 to March 2007. If any requirements were changed, I know that they were changed before I arrived in Air Headquarters, and they were changed not to suit a particular company, they were just changed. I am absolutely certain that as far as Air Headquarters, myself and my entire department was concerned, there were no changes brought about. So what is this payment about? Who will pay? Why will they pay? Is totally beyond my comprehension.
But Chief Marshal, the fact is that three of your cousins were liaising with this Italian firm. Their names have come out, and very clearly Italians believe in court that they have reason to understand and come to the conclusion that these cousins of yours received the money. What exactly was the role your cousins were playing in the purchase of the VVIP choppers?
How? I have not a clue. But let me also tell you that when I confronted or asked my cousins some time ago, when these reports first came out in Indian Express, all I can tell you is what they told me. And they said, yes, we know these Italians, and we've known them for 15-20 years or some time frame like that, that we have had business dealings with them, that we have never dealt at all in the defense sector, and personally I have no knowledge of their having dealt in the defense sector. All I can say is I know nothing about it. Now, the fact is that there is a report. What it is all about, I would like to find out myself. I haven't had the time to do it.
Got it. Sir, but don't you find it strange that air staff requirements were changed from 18,000 feet to 15,000 feet? Why were these changed? And if they were not changed by Air Headquarters, who changed it, when and why?
Well, there is some very good reason. Every time requirements are changed, it is not necessarily to suit a particular supplier. Sometimes requirements are changed for very professional reasons, and I hope professionals apply their mind, and this kind of thing, we should not say that no requirement should be changed, because that will be not be good for the system.
No, but were they changed to benefit a particular company? Were these ASRs changed only then Finmeccanica made the grade? It wasn't making the grade earlier.
But nobody else was making the grade either. Please understand that in the year 2000, and it must be clearly understood, in the year 2000, requirements were framed for a VVIP helicopter that could fly till 18,000 feet. Okay? Yes. That could operate at 18,000 feet. This is partly, if you recall, the then Defense Minister, Mr. Fernandez, used to go to Siachen. And I suspect that these were, you know, 18,000 feet figure just didn't come out from, you know, drop from the sky. It was taken because they needed a helicopter that could operate at those helipads. All we know is that in the, when the tender was issued or the request was issued, now I have no access to the official information, but I know from my knowledge and from my conversations, that in 2003 it transpired that only one helicopter in the world could fly at that 18,000 feet because not many helicopters are designed to operate at that altitude. It was then a decision was taken. I mean, actually, two things went wrong. One is it became only one helicopter. And that helicopter was also not acceptable to the SPG because this cabin height of that helicopter was very low. And they said, soldiers cannot stand. You know, our gunmen will not be able to stand in the helicopter straight. So for these two reasons, the Prime Ministerial Office, I think, wrote that we need to reconsider the requirements. So forget about going to Siachen. Let us just worry about crossing the Zojila Pass. These were discussions. And based on that, 15,000 feet was. Now, the 15,000 applied to the whole world. It was not to Augusta. In fact, one of the charges was that Augusta is an expensive aircraft, so now we don't normally, we go for the lowest tender. I don't think this is correct to say that in 2003, we changed the requirements to suit a particular company. I think it was changed because the SPG need and the fact that there was a single vendor.
H.E. Tyagi, we spoke to your predecessor just a few moments ago, Air Chief Marshal Krishnaswamy, who said something very significant. He said, this is not a defense procurement, it's a VVIP procurement, and the Indian Air Force itself has very little, you know, latitude to make any decisions as far as this is concerned. Is that your contention as well, that if anything was changed, if any specifications were altered, the Prime Minister's office, the SPG, they are answerable more than the Air Force and you as an individual?
Finally, the Air Force had initially made out the requirements, because the process is the Air Force made out the requirement and they are approved by the Ministry. So that is the process, and that process must have been followed in this case. All I know is that the requirements were changed. Again, if the requirements were changed, remember, it is the MOD that must change the requirements, because that is the process. But they were changed at the recommendation of the Prime Ministerial Office.
Give me a moment, Chief Tyagi. Just stay with us for a second. Sanjeev Tyagi, I am told, is joining us on this broadcast. He is a cousin of the Air Chief. He is one of the people who's been named who facilitated the payment to Air Chief Marshal Tyagi. Sanjeev Tyagi, you've seen what has come out in the Italian courts. You're hearing also what the Air Chief is saying. What is it that you have to say? An Italian court believes that you facilitated payment to the Air Chief for the purchase of these 12 VVIP helicopters.
Absolutely wrong, totally malicious. I have nothing to do, and I have spoken to my cousin. He is absolutely not involved in this. There is no question of any payment, because we are not connected at all. I don't know anything. My knowledge is only about this television and the press. I have nothing to do. That is what all I have to say.
Are you a defense agent? Nothing. Were you involved in the Augusta Westland helicopter deal?
No, I don't even know that company. I know nothing about that company. My only knowledge is from the newspaper and TV channel. I don't know why my name has come and where Chief Marshal Tyagi's name has come. I have absolutely nothing to do.
Thank you very much. But do you know, Sanjeev, just for a moment, because these are important questions, do you know the gentleman involved in the Fenmeccanica deal? Guido Hashkak, Carlo Garosa, Christian Mikkel, do you know these people? Okay, Sanjeev just disconnected the phone. He says he has no idea about any of these people. He's made his point and he's cut the call. But I want to go back to Air Chief Marshal Tyagi, because the BJP is now finding a political dimension to this story. They're raising the question of why the CBI probe was delayed for over a year. These charges have been swirling since March, February 2012. The MOD knew about it, Mr. Antony knew about it. They say because it's an Italian company, therefore the government dragged its feet and didn't order a probe, Air Chief Marshal Tyagi.
No, I have no comments to make. I have no idea what the information available to the ministry was, and it will be very wrong for me to look what BJP says, what Congress says has got nothing to do with me. I was a simple fighter pilot, and I have led a retired life for the last 6 years. What they say, I am not a political animal. So please understand, I can only answer to you what happened in Air Headquarters. And other than that, I would like to still, I have no comment to make.
Air Chief Tyagi, you know, considering that the Italian investigation began over a year ago, and the Indian government was fully aware of the gravity of the allegations being investigated by the Italian authorities, do you think there's something amiss that the government waited a full year before ordering this CBI probe?
I don't know, Shiv, how much that I would like to comment. I cannot, because I don't have the facts with me. I know for fact, however, that the ministry answered some questions in the parliament. And in one of the TV channels, it was also telecast, that the government has said that they carried out an internal probe. Whatever that means, I have no details available. And that they were, because of their internal probe, they could not proceed further. Yes, there were reports in the newspaper that and from Italy that there was some scandal brewing there. What exactly those details are, I am not privy to that. But I would like to believe that, and I know the system, newspaper articles like this come out, nobody just goes to sleep, okay? Because it can blow in the people's faces. Please understand, I am quite convinced that the ministry must have done some work. Now, what that work was, I am out of the government, they don't share with me, so I will have no idea. But I cannot believe that everyone went to sleep and said, all is well with the world, let's not do anything. Something must have been done.
No, but the question is, why was the probe not ordered? That's an important question. Gaurav has a question for you, actually. Air Chief, Doska Tyagi, Julie Tyagi and Sandeep Tyagi, your cousins, they deal with Italian firms. That is something that you're not denying. They do have deals with Italian firms, don't they? They operate with Italian companies.
I cannot deny that.
Because that is what Italian government sources are also saying, that they deal with these firms and it's through them the money came. Are you not aware of their dealings in Italy?
Because they are my cousins doesn't mean I look at their balance sheets and probe into their businesses. They are my buas sons. We are relatives. We meet very often. Not very often, but we meet often. But I have to say that I have no clue about what kind of business they done with the Italians.
But they do. Just they like do have I don't business think they have a clue Italy.
Of my relationships with others. Sorry?
They do have business interests in Italy.
Not in Italy. They have business interests in India. To the best of my knowledge. If they have business interests in Italy, then I am blissfully unaware of it.
Air Chief, do you know Mr. Orsi? Do you know Guido Hashkat? Do you know Carlo Garosa? Do you know Kristen Mikkel? Have you ever met any of these people?
Yes, I have met Carlo, whatever his full name is. I know him only as Carlo.
Carlo Garosa,
I met them in my cousin's place in some wedding or some family wedding and things like that. So it will be wrong for me to say I don't know them. Of course I met them.
Have you met any of the other three gentlemen
but
I named as well?
I have to tell you that
Guido, Kristen Mikkel,
no, I don't
Mr.
know Orsi, at least if I have met him, then I don't remember. You must also understand, if I met them as a chief, then I met so many heads of so many companies that it is impossible to remember their names. Impossible. I didn't remember them when I was the chief. It is now 6 years down the line, I will never remember them. So I may have met some of them, but I can't recall.
No, but did you meet them with your cousins while you were still chief, sir? At your cousin's residence while you were still chief?
No. Yeah, I don't want to go into this family affair. This is a family thing. But when I was the chief, we had some difficulties in the family. So I did not meet. You know, our relationship was such.
But was that relationship strained on account of the fact that they were pushing for defense deals, your cousins? Was that the reason?
No. That happened long before I became the chief. Sure. That is something personal. I don't want to talk about on
that.
The camera.
Respect that.
Air Chief Tyagi, you know, given that you've had some time now to look at these, allegations, your name cropping up in, verified court documents in Italy, what is your assessment? You know, there cannot be smoke without a fire. Why specifically your name has cropped up in these documents? Do you have, do you have a sense, do you suspect why this may have happened?
No, Shiv. I have to be honest. Firstly, I'm in a bit of a state of shock, and I have to admit it, because, when you see your photograph splashed on the headlines of the newspaper being accused of bribery, corruption, it is shocking. It is also shocking because it is not only shocking for me. I'm just wondering what it is means to the Indian Air Force. It is terrible. So I once this newspaper came out, I only came back from the walk at 8:30. Actually, I've been inundated with the calls, and the cameras have been on me. I haven't even had time to think what it was all about. All I can say is that bribery is generally for a consideration. Why would anybody pay me the bribery? Because I can't believe that I was considered to anybody at any time.
Air Chief, several of the officers who've called me through the day, through the morning, have spoken and vouched for your integrity and have said you were an officer par excellence, known in professional circles for his impeccable, unimpeachable integrity. Do you believe, Air Chief Tyagi, that there is a possibility that gentlemen close to you who shared a relationship with you could have misused your name, sir, promised an Italian firm that their helicopters will be purchased, misused your name to get the money and keep it themselves? Do you believe you could have been a pawn in this big defense scheme, sir?
I don't know. How can I say this? Really, I have no answers for it, because I don't have sufficient information to comment, really. And I would like to reserve my comment till I know a little more. All I know is right now, the fact is that there have been accusations. And I can only say that to clear my own name, I would like to see the Raksha Mantri has ordered a CBI inquiry. For me, the faster that takes place, the sooner it takes place, the better it is for everybody.
Air Chief Tyagi, while you were the Chief of Air Staff, was there any point of time when anything about the entire procurement process came across as suspicious to you? Was there any government pressure? Did you speak out about your suspicions? Was there anything amiss at any point of time in the procurement of these helicopters while you were chief or after?
No, never. People have been asking me questions about political interference and political pressures. I say this with complete confidence. No such thing ever took place.
No, because questions are also being asked, Air Chief Marshal, about why India picked up, a poor nation like India or a developing country like India, went out and bought these VVIP choppers, which even the United States found too costly for its own VIPs. Even President Obama felt it was too expensive for him to have. And yet the Indian government went and bought these super expensive luxury VVIP choppers?
Firstly, why President Obama said it is maybe for different reasons. If he found them expensive, he found them expensive. But please understand that they were British made. They were bought in George Bush's time. There was a lot of pressure whether they look at the American president, he's going to fly in a British helicopter. There were many reasons, and we can have a debate on it separately. Why did Indian government buy? Well, there is a process, there is a procedure, you know, budgeting, of financing, of approvals. The CCS approves it. There were reasons why this helicopter met the technical requirements others didn't meet. As far as I'm concerned, the process is pretty well laid out, and I know for sure that in this case, it was followed to the T.
But was this your actions, were these the actions of the Indian Air Force, or was it the SPG that wanted certain specifications and it was the SPG that pushed this deal through, or certain officers in the SPG?
Look, you were just quoting my predecessor. The PMO very specifically said that the SPG has to have a role in it. But this altitude change was, I don't think it had anything to do with the SPG. I'm not certain of it because I've not seen the documents, but I don't think they had a role to play in as far as the altitude was concerned.
Because
that's very
technical. This is now being called Bofors 2, Air Chief Marshal Tyagi. And as we head into election season, the ghost of an Italian firm paying off Indian officials for the purchase of a defense equipment is going to create a lot of political noise. And therefore, the imperative is that the probe really gets conducted quickly, so we know who took the money. And why is it that your name has come out in the first place, sir?
I would like to actually second the motion and say let's conduct the probe in the fastest possible time.
So you're saying, as we end this interview with you, sir, that your conscience is absolutely clear, that there is no question
of you having
taken even a single rupee from any Italian firm for helping facilitate the purchase of these VIP choppers.
In the whole interview, somebody has to tell me what was this assistant provided. No, my conscience is absolutely clear. In fact, I have, if I'm raising my voice, it is only because this is the 50th time since morning I am repeating it. Of course, it's clear, and let there be an inquiry and clear the name. That's it. That's my requirement, actually.
Mr. Are you then contemplating also legal action against the officials who've named you? Because if you say that your conscience is clear, will you then take action against the officials who say they paid you money if they didn't?
I don't know. I don't even know what is written in that report. Allow me to think. Allow me to consult, and then we shall decide.
Shiv, quickly.
Chief, quick final question. Could you clarify for us whether you will now, you know, since you have a relationship with the Ministry of Defense, will you now unilaterally approach them and offer, you know, to cooperate and give them any information possible as part of this investigation?
You mean you are wanting me to go and say I'm here? No, the inquiry has been ordered. There's a process, and I will go. I mean, I'm available for the inquiry. But if you are going to say that I should now go to somebody, in Ministry of Defense, stand in front of him and pray to him that, you know, please question me, I will not be doing that.
And you're not fully sure of the involvement of your cousins. You're saying you hope that they didn't misuse your name, but you're not certain that they didn't promise on your behalf that they would help push this deal.
What I would like to say is I know nothing about it.
I'm going to leave it over there, Chief Marshal Tyagi, for joining us with your thoughts. We don't want to jump in judgment one way or the other. There's a report in an Italian court. You're contesting the arguments made in those court documents. The CBI probe should have really been ordered long time back. The government has had more than a year. They didn't move an inch, didn't order a CBI probe. We didn't need to wait for the arrest of the CEO of this firm. This probe could have been ordered long back, and now we would have known who's guilty and who took money, if at all any money was exchanged.